Mapping Food Deserts in Southern California, Part 11, using the CLIP tool. In the previous video, you learned how to download data from ArcGIS online. In this video, you will learn how to use the CLIP tool. In this chapter, you learned that an overlay operation is a spatial operation in which two or more datasets are superimposed on one another to evaluate the relationship between features that occupy the same geographic space. In the step, you perform an overlay operation called a CLIP. When performing a CLIP operation, a polygon layer, called the CLIP feature, acts like a cookie cutter. In this instance, you will use the projected grocery store layer as the input feature and the population and poverty layer as the CLIP feature. The result will be a grocery store layer with points only within the counties of Los Angeles, Orange, San Bernardino, Riverside, San Diego, and Imperial. Using what you learned in a previous step, open the ARC toolbox. Expand the analysis tools. Then extract. Locate the CLIP tool. Double-click the tool to open it. The input features is the layer to be clipped. For the input features, use the drop-down menu to select the grocery store layer. The CLIP feature is the shape used to clip the input. For the CLIP feature, choose the population and poverty layer, which represents the study area. For the output feature class, be sure to browse to your working folder. Call the file SoCal_groceries. Leave all other default settings as they are. When you're ready, click OK. When the CLIP operation is complete, remove the original grocery store layer from the table of contents. You should now have a grocery store layer in Southern California. The problem with the Southern California grocery store layer is that it contains information about all types of grocery stores, large and small. If you recall, a food desert is a community, neighborhood, or region where people have limited access to affordable, nutritious food because they live far from a supermarket or large grocery store. In terms of food access and quality, larger stores often provide access to a variety of food departments, including fresh produce, baked goods, dairy, seafood, and meats. According to a 2009 report to Congress by the United States Department of Agriculture, a store should have an annual sales volume of at least $2 million to be considered a large grocery store or supermarket. Using what you learned in a previous step, perform an attribute query on the Southern California grocery store layer. Select the stores with a daily sales volume greater than or equal to $5,480. Export the selected features as a new shapefile and save to your working folder. Call the file Large Grocery Stores. When done, add the new layer to the map. Clear the selected records and remove the Southern California grocery store layer from the table of contents. In the next video, you will learn how to use the buffer tool and the erase tool.